Hey there, Cosmic Warriors, and welcome back to another video. And if you are new here, my name is Hannah. I am a Western practical astrologer. Okay, so following on from my most recent videos all about your Pluto in Capricorn story, we are going to take some time to explore your Pluto in Aquarius story. So what about the next 20 years, right? What does this next era, this next generation have in store for your sign as Pluto enters Aquarius from the 19th of November? Yes, we are approaching this new cycle. A whole new chapter is beginning. So we're going to get into it. Now, before we do, please make sure to comment, like, subscribe, all that good stuff if you want to keep updated with more videos. And if you do like the video, give it a like, and that would be very much appreciated. And if you're interested in booking a reading with me, you can visit my website, hannahselsewhere.com. There you can also find my astrology products over there if you would like. Okay, so what we're going to do firstly is we're just going to look at some of the dates, the important dates with Pluto being in Aquarius. Now, Pluto was in Aquarius from March until June, so that was about 3 months. That was back in 2023. So try to think of that transit as dipping your toe into what could possibly come up, right? It was sort of like a temptation, have you thought of this? Maybe, who knows? These things could change, right? It was more like an introduction to what the next 20 years could offer you. But then you see there is a much longer transit, January of this year, 2024, all the way up until September. So 8 months, an 8 month period, really then giving us more, as if we're putting our arm or our leg into the water, so to speak. And so perhaps in this way, you've gotten an even bigger taste of what is to come. And the other thing about it too, I suppose, is consider how Pluto was retrograde, right? With Pluto being retrograde in Aquarius during certain times, during certain periods, that could have been a really useful time period to kind of go, okay, well, let me journal, let me jot this down and maybe come up with some conclusions. Let me see the patterns, right? Yes, paying attention to certain cycles and patterns and themes, and then maybe gaining some kind of insight as to what the future could have in store for you. But then you see, we're coming up to the big one, the big show. It is time. From the 19th of November, 2024, for the next 20 years or so, Pluto will remain in Aquarius. So what I just want to take a moment to do here is to explain what is Pluto all about and what is Aquarius all about. And actually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to explain what Aquarius is about first. So Aquarius is this sign that can be quite futuristic. We may see here already, which to be fair, we have noticed more of the AI stuff, more of those technological advancements coming up, flipping rocket ships going up into the sky, and just all sorts of mayhem and madness already to do with technology. So we see the futuristic themes. And so we could perhaps predict then that more is to come, right? This greater push for things that are more technological and online. But here is the interesting, refreshing thing about Aquarius. And I'm also kind of speaking from experience here, right? I just want to say, I'm very Aquarius dominant. My sun is there, Mercury and Saturn. Right. The thing about Aquarius is, see when the crowd is going in one way, okay? The collective society pushes for one thing or heads off in one direction. Aquarius is the archetype, is the sign that says, ho, 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 hold on, hold on, hold on, hold on. Let me just take a minute. Let me just sit back and observe what is happening right now. Do I really want to jump on the bandwagon? Do I really want to follow this trend or this thing that's popular and cool? What do I think, right? Very much about you having your own mind, you having your own opinions. So as society might push in one direction, when we think about the likes of AI, okay, we could also see a lot of people heading in the opposite way and saying, actually, no, I don't want my whole personality and my whole life to be published online. I don't want that for my future. I don't want that for my children, for the future generations. Or we could see people standing up against authority, standing up against what is considered to be the new normal, what becomes normal. Because I suppose that's the thing. What is popular is often seen as normal, but actually, Aquarius is the archetype that says just because it's popular doesn't mean that you should do it. It's like that thing of just because someone's going to jump off a bridge or put their hand in the fire, it doesn't mean you should as well. So, very interesting to think about here. And so, when we consider Pluto, right, Pluto is about our psyche. It's about our unconscious drives, motivations, and compulsions. So maybe in this respect, Pluto and Aquarius can usher in this greater self-control, especially when it comes to the online world, the online space. We may be able to assess and analyze our own potential negative traits to do with our social media usage. Maybe being able to identify, oh, hold on a second, what about my privacy? How is this information being shared with others? And, you know, you could also argue that what I'm saying is somewhat hypocritical. Here we go. There's another Aquarius theme, the hypocrite. The reason why I'm saying this is because we're already there, essentially, right? It's kind of like saying, well, you know, we've already been posting X, Y, and Z on Instagram and Facebook all these years. So really, does it make much of a difference to do it on other online, in other online spaces? And, you know, you're a hypocrite and things like this. But I still think Aquarius provides us with this opportunity in that you're allowed to change your mind. You're allowed to get to a certain point and go, oh, I've been doing this for so long. This Saturn, right? Saturn is, it's this longevity. Saturn rules Aquarius. Uranus rules Aquarius. The Saturnian side can show up as, I'm committing to this plan, I'm doing it, and I'm going for it. And don't get it twisted, you know, Aquarians can be very, very determined people, ambitious people, very much so with that Saturnian influence. So there can be this consistency, but here comes Uranus. Uranus is this somewhat electrifying slash refreshing energy in that it reminds us as a collective and it reminds Aquarians that yes, they are allowed to change their minds. They're allowed to go, you know what? Yeah, I've been doing this for so long. I don't want to do it anymore. And this is the thing about Aquarius. Aquarius can just go, nope, done. That's it. And they leave whatever that thing was in the past. It may sound extreme, but it can maybe with Pluto being in Aquarius, it can be this whole feeling of, that's dead to me. It's buried. It's gone. I'm moving on my life, right? Aquarius is about the future. Aquarius is about moving forward. This is a sign of innovation, being a visionary, and being actually pretty rebellious. Rebelling, my goodness. We are going to see this intensified. Now, we could also argue with Pluto being in Aquarius that there could be greater riots and distress, chaos, anarchy within society. And we also have kind of witnessed and observed these kinds of things with the tasters of Pluto being in Aquarius the past couple of years. So yes, there is this side. And with the shadow stuff, there could also be this spying stuff, being sneaky, cunning, manipulative, trying to manipulate others to bend to our will, because there can be a part of Aquarius that can be very cold and detached. And maybe with Pluto, these things could intensify, but not in a very healthy way. But to turn this more toward more of a perhaps a positive way to look at it, I want you to remember that emotional detachment isn't a bad thing. Emotional detachment can be very healthy for us, in that if we find or feel ourselves becoming emotionally enmeshed with a person, a job, a thing, then emotional detachment is quite beautiful, in that we can go, why am I attaching to this so much? Why do I care so much, right? Aquarius energy cares, and I mean it. This is a sign that really cares about others. But just as much, Aquarius can reach a breaking point, can reach a point where this archetype reminds us, why do you care? You don't have to. Why are you giving so much of yourself to people who don't appreciate it or don't value what you're offering here? So this is where detachment can come in handy. It can be quite useful to us. So those are just some things that I wanted to highlight with Pluto being in Aquarius. And of course, I could share more. I could, but what I want to do is I want to focus on your signs and what could be in store for you over the next 20 years based on your sign and where Pluto shows up in your chart. And I will also say this, if you would like just more information about the collective themes here with Pluto being in Aquarius, there is a post I have written and it's published on my Instagram. If you just go to the Pluto signs highlight section, I have Pluto through all of the signs throughout the years. So there is that section all about Pluto and Aquarius. If you just want more themes and just potential things that could come up during the transit. Okay. So on that note, we are going to get into your signs. Yes. Thank you so much for being here. Right. So what we're going to do is we're going to begin from Libra and then we will work our way through to Pisces. This is going to be part two. If you would like to watch the horoscopes for your sign, if you know maybe you've got Aries 3 to Virgo there, then there is that part one video available. Okay, so Libra, what will Pluto and Aquarius have in store for you? So Pluto and Aquarius will transit your fifth house, Libra. So what we could see for you unfold throughout the next 20 years are these death and rebirths, these transformations, these renewals tied to things like how it is that you express yourself, thinking about self-expression, your individuality, your ego. My goodness, this could be rebirths when it comes to the ego. Pride could also be a part of this. And maybe as well, we could see significant shifts to do with children. So naturally, this could be about you having children, or this could be the relationship that you currently have with your children and how things may just change and progress and transform throughout the next 20 years. Maybe even a part of this is recognizing any power struggles within your romantic relationships, or even when it comes to the relationships that you have with your children. But remember, with this being Aquarius, there's something very innovative and different and original about this energy. There is also something quite intellectual and objective, and maybe being able to see things from all angles. Hey, you know what? This could even be a case of your creativity and your artwork transforming greatly. There could even be this strong passion that you possess when it comes to a certain art form, when it comes to a creative pursuit over the next 20 years. Hey, perhaps such matters are also linked to your children, right? Even having fun with your children, making time for play and spontaneity. But then with children to the side, a lot of this is about fun and play and spontaneity within your own life. There's something highly passionate and enthusiastic about this energy over the next 20 years for you, Libra. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to explore Uranus through the signs, and then we're going to look at Saturn through the signs. So Uranus then is about breakthroughs, breaking free, sudden changes. It's about rebellion and exploring alternatives. And then what we want to think about is how these things will be tied to that of your creativity and your hobbies and your forms of recreation, things like that. Then Saturn will show us more of this structure, this building process, this kind of stability that will be formed over the next 20 years. Again, we relate that back to things like your creativity, your relationship with your children and romantic partners and so on. But do remember with Saturn, this the kind of Aquarius side of Saturn is somewhat original and unique. Experimentation tends to come up. So yes, remember these qualities. But currently, Uranus is in your eighth house and will continue to be there until 2027. So there's quite a bit here coming up to do with vulnerability, intimacy, perceived weaknesses even, getting to the core, getting to the heart of a matter. Trust and commitment is also quite a big theme here. So we could see some breakthroughs with respect to the likes of intimacy and trust, and then naturally relate that back to that of romance and lovers and just love in general, right? The fifth house can be about the ways in which we show affection and the ways in which we express our love overall. And that naturally, that love could extend to friends and family members, for instance. Still, Uranus in the eighth, I think for you, has brought up a lot of change, sudden changes, unexpected changes to do with the likes of sensuality and even, I would say, intensity related to sensuality or intensity related to materials and your resources. So there's still more to come as Uranus continues through the eighth house until 2027. Then we move on to 2027 to 2034. Uranus will move into your ninth house in Gemini. So for you, Libra, we could see on the horizon here some disruption, possible chaos, even exciting and electrifying moments related to that of your higher education, further training, right? Wanting to advance in some way, shape, or form, wanting to add to your credentials. There's some form of achievement in this, I think, especially intellectually. Especially when it comes to learning, teaching, sharing, broadcasting. Creativity could also be a part of this. It could play a role. Hey, you think about Uranus in the ninth, Pluto in the fifth, you know, there could be some crazy mad creative project you take on, and then that is sort of published, broadcasted to the world. This could be some kind of documentary, for instance. Maybe this is about reporting, or this is about long distance travel, or publishing in some way, shape, or form, right? Publications and advertising as well, you know, really showcasing your works and your teachings with the world, and connecting and joining up with like-minded people, right? People who maybe share similar interests to you, right? Then we move on to 2034 to 2041. Uranus will transit your 10th. Well, very, very fascinating, this one. I actually know of a close relative who was born with Uranus in Cancer in the 10th. But anyway, Uranus transiting the 10th house throughout this period could be unpredictable shifts and changes related to your professional lives, your purpose, your life's work. So just to give an example, you could be a Libra and perhaps you are focusing a lot on your career, but then there are these sudden shifts, there are these sudden changes which lead to you then being more within the home, and it's not so focused on career anymore. But that's just one example, of course. But you could even switch this around and look at it the other way, right? Where it is more about being at home, and then suddenly you're like, okay, well, I actually want to think about my contributions to society and how I wish to give back to my communities, and just making a difference there. But coming across as nurturing, as protective, as empathetic, very supportive toward other people's needs. Then we move on to 2041 to 2043, and Uranus will be in Leo, ending Pluto in Aquarius. So Uranus will be in your 11th house at the end of this transit, indicating some kind of sudden changes or breakthroughs, rebellion, nonconformity with relation to grips and your public contributions there, your social contributions, should I say. We could see your priorities changing in terms of the kinds of groups that you want to be a part of. Maybe there is greater desires for fun and play and pleasure and just letting your hair down. Yeah, something fun here. Do keep in mind that with this, Uranus would then be in the opposite house of where Pluto is. So we could see then these bursts of creativity, these bursts of passion and innovation, and being quite inventive, just being very curious about fun and playful projects and how those creative projects can even be shared, can be shared with the world, or they can make a difference to society in some way, shape, or form. So that's Uranus. And I also want to mention, remember those overlaps between the dates. The reason why this is because of retrogrades, things like that. So yeah, just remember there will be some overlap. So look more into those if you like. I mean, for example, there will be the sextile between Saturn and Pisces and Uranus and Taurus. And then there will also be that sextile between Saturn and Aries and then Uranus and Gemini. So that will be more at the beginning of Pluto and Aquarius. So maybe look into those aspects for yourself. But let's now turn our attention to Saturn. So remember, Saturn is going to show us form and structure and responsibility, reward, dedication, karma, hard lessons. So with Pluto being in Aquarius here, we notice that Saturn has been hanging out in your sixth house and will continue to be there as until 2026. So again, just remember overlaps. There is a part of it where Saturn dips into Aries throughout 2025, but I digress. We have noticed for you, Libra, that you've been really focusing on what is a priority for you on a day-to-day basis. a lot of having to reorganize things, move things about, to be quite open and flexible to new ways of doing things. Maybe this is about feeling more spiritually aligned. Maybe this is even about experiencing more moments of relaxation and rest, just trying to take it easy when you can, showing yourself some kind of compassion. Maybe such things are linked to your health and your well-being. And of course, this could also be something related to work and your services. So something that you may be building for the future there. When you link that back to Pluto in the fifth, again, we come back to creativity. We come back to certain creative pursuits of yours. Then from 2026 until 2028, Saturn will move into your seventh house. So Saturn will actually oppose you, Libra. So Saturn in Aries could very well reflect back at you the ways in which you might be somewhat blocked or limited or restricted when it comes to asserting yourself, when it comes to standing up for yourself or getting what you want. But I find it quite interesting because when we look a little further into this, Chiron is hanging out in your seventh, and Chiron is not it's not a part of this that I've explored for the signs, but just with Chiron in your seventh house currently and for the past few years, perhaps there has been a lot of triggers that have come up for you with relation to relationships and partnerships, and, you know, maybe feeling anger, feeling frustrated, especially when you don't get your way or when somebody else doesn't get their way. But Saturn coming along, I think, and following this path, it could be pointing towards something mature, something wise, something responsible, right? So such as recognizing that you can't control the actions of other people. You can only control yourself, just as one example there. Also, you know, Saturn in the seventh could be great for business, right? I mean, Libra, you are the sign of contracts and agreements and business relations. So, you know, there could be some business partnerships that form because of your actions, because of you being somewhat of a go-getter. Then from 2028 until 2030, Saturn will enter the eighth. Right. So think of it this way. Uranus has been traveling through your eighth house and will be there until 2027, bringing up all sorts of perhaps mayhem and chaos and disruption when it comes to the likes of intimacy and shared resources. I mean, maybe there have been unexpected losses in your life, and yes, those losses could be related to actual people, but those losses could also be material, financial, you know, thinking about ownership, possessions there. So Saturn then coming along, which to be fair as well, you know, there could be loss, but there could also be gains, right? Gains through other people's finances and money too, but there is something unexpected about Uranus, right? Still, as Saturn then starts to follow that same path, this is where we see the building, the structure, the growth in terms of, okay, there's a solid foundation underneath. Now it's time to build brick by brick from there, to maybe explore more deeply, more closely. Okay, what about my earnings and my investments? What about my business, especially if you are an entrepreneur? What about my, you know, your company, your organization, how you manage your time? Management could be a big part of this, right? Managing other people's money. But there is a seriousness, there is a dedication to this energy, of course. And of course, too, you know, Saturn transiting the eighth house could be you exploring any repressed emotions, especially related to intimacy and desire and sensuality. Could also then be about you coming to terms with the things that you find challenging to open up about, to be vulnerable about at times. And, you know, maybe a part of this too is your fears coming up related to security. Then when we move on to 2030 to 2032, Saturn will be in the ninth for you. So Saturn in the ninth could indicate more of this well-informed, well-educated energy, and coming across as I know what I'm talking about. I have studied this for years. I've been thinking about this, learning it, through every method, using every method possible. And so there's this self-respect, this integrity that is gained, and you perhaps being rewarded for your efforts, for your dedication related to a particular subject matter, for instance. Then again, you know, this could be about you really going over your philosophical beliefs and, well, your deeply held beliefs as well, and how those things are very much linked to your own mindset. You know, so this could be you assessing any negative thoughts or thoughts that hinder you, or thoughts that can just be overly harsh. But here's the thing, there will be the Saturn Uranus conjunction in Gemini at the end of June 2032, right? So that conjunction will usher in a new 45-year cycle within your ninth house here, Libra, to do with what? Well, to do with things like your higher education. We think about you achieving this educational diploma or degree, or finishing that course, or this could even be about mentorship, you being a teacher, you wanting to guide others. There's just a lot to do with education here, but maybe another way to look at this is via long distance travel. You know, so thinking about the kinds of people you reach with your voice, with your words, with your message. But whilst there is a part of it where you're going to gain respect because of your hard work, because of your effort, remember that with Saturn, it is about putting in the work. But also, there could be something quite surprising and exciting. Maybe travel is a part of this, like physically going to different destinations and hosting events, you know, literally hosting events, getting together with like minds, just spreading your message with the world there, Libra. Then we move on to Saturn entering your 10th house from 2032 to 2035. So we're going to see here greater structure and form being put into that of your vocation, your professional lives. Another way to look at this, of course, then just following on from a comment that was received, if this is more about retirement, you know, thinking more about your ages here, because I get it, we could all be at different stages of our lives here with Pluto through Aquarius. But when we think about the likes of retirement there, maybe it is about recognition. So being recognized for your works, for the building blocks that you've already put in throughout your life. So thinking about your life's work, your life's mission. So there's some recognition there that could very well come up. And then, of course, you know, this could also be about you taking another step forward and making things happen for the long haul. But again, qualities here with Cancer, when we think about it, could be your professional lives, your life's work, you being known for support, being a caregiver, being a nurturer. Then from 2035 to 2037, Saturn will move into your 11th house. So maybe actually this is about planning events or planning some kind of social thing, right? It could be a cause, a movement. It could be a creative project. Again, it could be a club. Maybe this is about you being in a position of authority in some way, shape, or form. And yes, there could also be some self-doubt related to confidence in some respects with Saturn in Leo, but this is also about embracing that challenge, so to speak, and being able to shine, to be in the spotlight when it comes to those social events, when it comes to group participations, when it comes to friendships. Then from 2037 to 2039, Saturn will be in the 12th house for you. So honestly, this part of the transit with Pluto being in Aquarius could be a bit more tricky, a bit more challenging, I would say, just because with Virgo in the 12th, it can indicate some anxious thoughts or feeling worried, a bit stressed out, maybe fearing that you've made the wrong decision, for example, I mean, quote unquote, the wrong decision, being quite concerned about perfectionism. So there could be some things that just resurface, right? Perfectionist stuff could resurface, and then you're kind of having to manage those thoughts or having to work through them and to remind yourself, I am enough, I've got this, I have made the right decision, it's going to be okay. Even just drawing from your own spiritual practices, making time throughout your day to tune in, to focus on, you know, settling your mind, being mindful of what comes up. And such matters could then naturally be linked to confidence and self-expression and your individuality. Then from 2039 to 2041, we have Saturn in your sign. So actually with this one, I want you to remember that Saturn is exalted. It is exalted in your sign. So there could actually be something quite honorable and practical, well-rounded, grounded, and steady and stable about this section, I think, this time period for you. I think a part of it is I've weighed out my options. I know what I'm doing. I've considered, moving on then to Saturn entering your sign, Libra, from 2039 to 2041. So this is where we're going to see you perhaps really achieving, succeeding, going after the things that you want, being quite dedicated and disciplined, bringing form there to things that you want to achieve. So basically just making a plan, right? Making a plan, going for it, and being able to weigh out your options as you do, and coming across as quite charming and social as you do. But there's also this respect that you get for how you relate, how you collaborate, how you contribute. Indeed, there could be some successes that come up within relationships here. And then closing Pluto in Aquarius, we've got Saturn in the second house from 2041 to 2043 for you. So this part of it could feel a bit like a power struggle. There could be intense feelings and emotions that come up. Maybe this is even about certain restrictions or limitations you face with respect to your resources and your finances, and you just want things to move on. You just want to control the situation. And maybe a part of it is to somewhat recognize that you can't control other people and that it is important to just give things time, to be patient with yourself. And then we also want to think about even how we relate that back to Pluto in some ways, because, you know, that financial stress, that financial tension could be related to your children, for instance. It could be related to romance or love or some hobby of yours. But the whole journey here, remember to relate the journey, the different parts of Saturn through the signs, Uranus through the signs, relate it back to that of this area of life, right? So this area of life about things like your hobbies, your forms of enjoyment, free time, play, and fun. Thank you so much, Libra. And now we're going to move on to Scorpio. Okay, let's now think about you, Scorpio. What does Pluto in Aquarius have in store for you throughout the next 20 years? So firstly, I want you to remember that Pluto is one of your chart rulers. And so what we want to think about here when exploring the chart ruler is your direction, this major area of your life being activated. So what is this area? Well, the fourth house rules things like your family life, your home, your living situation, even your garden or your backyard. This is also about your homeland, your heritage, your culture. So your family tree is very much activated with Pluto entering your fourth. And so with Pluto in Aquarius specifically, we could notice this reinventing yourself to do with family matters. You showing up as a rather strong and powerful individual within your home. You even experiencing transformations and renewals tied to your living situation. So of course, there could be some kind of loss when we think about Pluto endings, but there could also be new beginnings. There could be the rising up, right? And what I also want to say here, and I would like to be rather sensitive as I say this, we want to think about how the fourth house can pertain to family members, right? Especially our parents, grandparents, people who raised us, caregivers. So Pluto entering this sector of your chart could actually indicate some sort of loss, right? A death, for instance. And I don't want to say that as a way to create fear or you to freak out. You know, I'm just saying that this is a possibility when we see Pluto in the fourth. But you see, the other thing is that we could notice some power struggles with relation to family members, okay? And possibly pushing back or showing some sort of resilience when it comes to your family. And maybe even this is about how family will transform you, right? The kinds of relationships, bonds you have with your family could transform you. I mean, literally, this could be about you having a family of your own. This could even be about the transformations you experience from within because of moving, because of relocating. So a lot of home-related things here coming up with Pluto transiting the fourth. But now what we're going to do is we're going to explore Uranus through the signs and then Saturn. So I want you to remember here that Uranus is going to point to the likes of breakthroughs, disruptions, non-conformity, great change and rebellion, right? This desire, this urge to rebel. And then Saturn is going to point toward stability and structure, limitations, form, responsibility, but also karma and rewards that can come from responsibility is what I was trying to get at there. Yes, so I want you to remember these themes as I go through Uranus and Saturn. And then you also want to think about how, whenever I explore each segment, each chapter, so to speak, bring it back to that of family, home. Even your emotional security here, right? Your emotional needs, your emotional attachments, and how these parts of the self will indeed go through renewals. You will experience evolution and growth. Right. So Uranus is currently opposing you, Scorpio. Uranus has been in Taurus for a good while, and it will continue to be there until 2027. So with Uranus opposing you, you may be finding here that when it comes to relating, collaborating, connecting, joining up with others, things have been very sudden, unpredictable, the unexpected has happened. So we could notice here relationships just suddenly being about connection and new relationships, right? So relationships starting out of the blue. But then just as much, we can notice relationships suddenly coming to an end, coming to a close, right? Hey, you know what? What also comes to my mind here? Remember, the fourth house is also about closure, right? So how we gain closure, how we move forward after an ending, after a certain situation has been finalized. So I just want you to remember that. So Pluto there could very well also indicate some sort of rebirth when it comes to those areas. So back to Uranus. Indeed, we notice sudden changes and disruptions, things being rather chaotic when it comes to how stable and steady your relationships feel. Of course, you know, by relationship, this could be your spouse, this could be a business partner, this could be a close friend as examples. But you see, with Uranus being there in the seventh, we want to relate it in some ways back to the fourth, and we want to think about how, sure, there could be these sudden shifts and changes regarding family, close people who you feel close to, even people who you trust or thought you could trust. Then we move on to Uranus entering your eighth house from 2027 to 2034. And I actually think this is where we're going to get to the real depths of change for you. I'm going to be rather, hopefully, sensitive as I say this, but I want to be honest in that Pluto in the fourth, Uranus in the eighth, I see as being quite a challenging period to go through. Maybe Libra can help you out in some ways, because for Libra, Pluto was in the fourth, and then there's that part of Uranus in the eighth for them. But anyway, what can this indicate? I think there could be sudden losses, sudden closures. Again, this could be about family, but hey, this could also be about your mind, okay? Your psyche. Perhaps Scorpio, this transit of Pluto through the fourth could actually be very healing for you. There could be a lot that comes up psychologically for you. This could be a good way for you to just do a lot of inner work, shadow work, so much exploration here. And, you know, you could really be surprised by what you discover when you just look beneath the surface that little bit, when you explore your unconscious. And thinking even especially about coming to terms with anything you repress. And I also can't help but think that these areas, these matters, link to that of your sibling relationships, the neighborhood you grew up in. So there could be something here about the past that's trying to push through and trying to remind you that maybe this thing hasn't been fully resolved. Or perhaps it is about integrating certain parts of the self so that you can move forward with this greater resilience and inner strength. Again, a lot of this could be more psychological and mental with Gemini. Maybe being open about your true feelings can be of a beneficial thing as you move through this part of the transit. Then, from 2034 to 2041, Uranus will enter the ninth house for you in Cancer. So this could actually be where Scorpio, unexpectedly, suddenly, you decide to relocate. I mean, literally, it could be that you move to a completely different country, but you do that with your family, okay? You do that with your partner, your spouse. When we think about Pluto in the fourth and then Uranus in the ninth, then again, this could be some kind of caregiving course or a supportive course that provides you with certain tools. And then that could even lead to something quite successful, some sort of achievement for the long run. And then I guess in this way, this leads us on to Uranus in the 10th, because Uranus will enter Leo in the 10th from 2041 to 2043. So just, it will be there for longer, of course, but this is just to close off Pluto and Aquarius. So we could see actually a new career path. We could see you changing directions when it comes to your professional lives, when it comes to the kinds of positions you take on. Maybe those positions involve leadership or performance or entertainment, or they have something to say about you stepping into the spotlight and being confident, confident about your successes, confident about your wins. But essentially, there could be some sort of disruption. And hey, you know, innovation when it comes to your vocation, even your life's work and your purpose there, Scorpio. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to explore Saturn. Remember, Saturn is going to show us how you're going to be building, what structures are going to be put in place there. So Saturn has been hanging out in your fifth house since 2023, will be there until 2026, which I just want to say here, I've been saying this for everybody, remember the overlaps. There are overlaps between the dates because of retrogrades, right? You know, certain planets will dip into one sign, then retrograde back into the other, right? So yes, look further into retrogrades and those overlaps. But with Saturn in the fifth, what we see here is you really focusing in on your hobbies, the things you want to create, right? Your creative pursuits, you becoming stronger, you being really determined actually when it comes to your hobbies and how your hobbies and your creative projects have something to say about your spiritual values, your morals, right? Your morals, your principles, how they have something even to say about your creativity in really artistic ways and your imagination, right? Your imagination just being brought to life. There's something about bringing form to your imagination through your arts here. Another possibility, of course, though, is there could be some lessons and maturity, possible wisdom tied to children, right? Having children, the relationship you already have with your children, even thinking about focusing a lot on your own intuition, your intuitive insights when it comes to your romantic relationships. Then from 2026 to 2028, we have Saturn entering your sixth. So this part of the transit, Scorpio says, it's time to get to work. It's time to reprioritize, reorganize a few things. It's time to think about certain roles that you want to take on within work, right? Your services, leadership positions, how you step into a position of authority, how you can take charge, how you can command respect, so to speak, right? And I think a big part of that is self-respect, actually. But yeah, so much about goal setting, being a bit of a leader, being a doer when it comes to your working life. So there is that. Then we move on to the next part from 2028 to 2030. Saturn will oppose you. Now, before we go any further, I just want to mention something about the overlap stuff. There is the Saturn in Pisces, sextile Uranus in Taurus. Then there will also be the Saturn in Aries, sextile Uranus in Gemini. So look more into those sextiles just for more information. But we will be looking to a certain conjunction coming up in Gemini here. But back to Taurus. So think of it like this, Scorpio. Uranus has been transiting your seventh house for the past number of years. And basically, we see the disruption, we see the surprises. Hey, you know, gettiness, There's electrifying energy, the aha light bulb moments as well going off when it comes to relationships and collaborations and business and contracts, agreements, all that good stuff, thinking about how those things are related to your security, right? But then Saturn will come along shortly after and sort of goes, right, time to build, time to consider the long haul. What have I learned? What did I really learn from Uranus and Taurus here? Now it's time to be a grown-up. Now it's time to mature in some ways. Now, I do understand that we're all at a different stage of our lives, right? It really depends on your age and everything as we explore Pluto and Aquarius. But even, you know, Saturn here could just be about commitment, or it could be about having some kind of control, so to speak, when it comes to agreements and contracts. And just, again, thinking more about your actions, consequences to your actions, thinking about the long haul. Again, I think these things could be related to your finances there. Now, from 2030 until 2032, Saturn will enter your eighth. So this could be where there is some struggle and setbacks and delays related to that of the psychological stuff that I was talking about earlier. Maybe just having to sit with a psychological matter, a psychological concern maybe, or it's just trusting that things will improve and to ride things out a little bit when it comes to intimate relationships, shared resources, managing other people's money, paying off debts. And the significant thing about all of this is the Saturn-Uranus conjunction will happen at the end of June 2032 in your eighth house in Gemini. So what this conjunction will usher in for you is, well, this new 45-year cycle to do with things like shared resources, shared accounts, how you just share with your significant other, or how it is that you do business. Management could be a big thing here. Considering what is said, being quite mindful about education and learning more. And as well, this stuff could be related to that of research, the occult, finding out the truth, you know, getting to the core of a situation. Maybe even this stuff is about communicating effectively when it comes to vulnerability and intimacy and trust, closeness, emotional bonding. These things become quite big themes, I think, for you, Scorpio. So this stuff then is linked to that of communication largely. And then also what we want to think about is, whilst there is the Saturnian part of this where it's more about seriousness, the long haul, integrity, Uranus adds exploring alternatives, trying something new, innovation, okay? So there could be some surprises that come up. Then from 2032 until 2035, Saturn will enter your ninth. So this could be where we see greater wisdom and understanding when it comes to higher education, or when it comes to something that you're trying to train in, right? So we think about a certain skill, a certain qualification, just how you wish to expand and improve in this way. But yes, there will be this dedicated approach, a disciplined approach, even having a plan, this step-by-step plan, coming across as an authority, a professional, a professional teacher, a professional mentor or guide, for instance. Then we move on to 2035 until 2037. Saturn will be in your 10th. So hey, this is an interesting journey, right? When we think about from the 5th to the 10th, but yes, we could see you really stepping into your power, your self-expression, gaining some kind of attention. The way you come across, just being very much, I know of my value here. I know of how much work I've been putting in. And there's that recognition, to be recognized as a leader, to be recognized as the creative director, for instance, to be recognized as that manager, that boss, that CEO, the entrepreneur, the business, the business owner, etc. And at the same time, you know, if it is that you work for a particular company or a firm at the time, it's still your contributions being recognized, your creative contributions, especially with it being in Leo. Then, oh, and by the way, just those things could very well be challenged by those family transformations as well, because Pluto is still in the 4th, right? But then from 2037 to 2039, we have Saturn in Virgo in the 11th. So we actually could see the impact that you make on society in some way, shape, or form, the help and the service that you provide into your teams and your organizations, the groups, clubs you're a part of. You could actually be that group organizer. We could see you really performing excellently when it comes to some kind of service related, could be a profession, it could be something that you're working toward, a responsibility. And maybe as well, a part of this is you refining your skills, improving, right? Making improvements when it comes to your group contributions, but just taking it step by step. Then from 2039 until 2041, we've got Saturn in the 12th. Now, this part of the transit, I think, especially if we consider Saturn being in your sign at the end of Pluto in Aquarius, this could be where you just take a moment, right? Even just taking a while to reflect, to really go within and go, what have I learned from the past however long, right? With Pluto first entering Aquarius, what's come up for me over these years? And what about my relationships? And how have I changed from the inside out when it comes to relationships? How have my opinions and my views changed? Especially whenever we think about how Libra tends to weigh out options and considers, okay, the pros and the cons. Maybe even this stuff is very spiritual. There's this spiritual quality being involved in the choices that you've made and the options that have been available to you. There's something very karmic about all of these realizations. And essentially, you know, a lot of this is about contemplating. And maybe too, even going on certain retreats with your significant other, your friend, your lover, just thinking about retreats and how those retreats will involve someone else or other people. But you see, ending the transit, hey, maybe this is why you need that retreat, right? Because it's like, hey, Saturn enters your sign toward the end of the transit from 2041 to 2043. And it sort of says, yeah, well, it's time to get to work here. It's time to put my best foot forward again. So much has changed when it comes to my home life. And, you know, maybe even a part of this is you literally owning property, maybe many properties, right, with Pluto in the 4th. Or this could be about you seeing how much change has happened within your family life, your home life, and the amount of things that have came up, right? What you've learned, how your responsibilities have transformed, how even your emotional world has changed quite significantly, and the things that maybe used to get to you, used to upset you, they don't as much, right? There's just something here about emotional responsibility and showing integrity, showing this determination, but also showcasing compassion, especially based on all the things that have happened up to that point, right? If it is, for example, that you've came up against really challenging situations emotionally within your family, maybe you come to the end of this transit, and sure, perhaps a part of this is having to dust yourself off slightly because it's like, wow, what the heck? But another part of it is, whoa, I've really changed. I'm not the person I was back then. And you can take time to consider your own personal part and what was required of you even to get through those hard times. Very interesting, Scorpio, for you with Saturn ending in your sign. The journey all the way through to that first house, it's like by the end of it, you're going to come out anew. But hey, this is you after all too, right, Scorpio? You know all too well about transformations and renewals. All right, Scorpio, thank you so much. Now we are going to focus on Sagittarius. Okay, moving on to you, Sagittarius. Right. What will Pluto and Aquarius have in store for your sign? So Pluto will be transiting your third house throughout the next 20 years. So with that, what we could see for you, Sagittarius, is things like your education and your learning really transforming. There could be some kind of evolutionary process that happens. This could be you evolving when it comes to the information that you learn about, share, write about. You know, just we think about the third house in terms of things like writing, reading, researching, distributing information to the world in some respects, especially with this being your sign, right, Sagittarius, because you're all about, okay, whenever I learn something new, I tend to pass it on to others and my own knowledge increases. So yeah, we could see something quite innovative in this way for you, something quite inventive. You actually thinking outside of the box more strongly, or coming up with these new visions, these somewhat original ideas about the future and your growth there. But you see, this could also be where psychological distress comes up. There could be some psychological patterns or compulsions, these unconscious themes, trying to kind of push through, and maybe these unconscious themes are tied to, well, communities, groups, friendships. We even think about the first group that we're born into, which would essentially be our family. So there could even be some unresolved traumas that you try to get to the bottom of. Maybe even this is about wanting to feel greater empowerment, of course, when it comes to the words you say and what you share with the world, but just greater empowerment even within a group setting. Okay, and seeing that your words do hold meaning, they hold value, and the words you say matter, right? Think about how your words can influence and impact others around you. Maybe even this is about getting to the heart of a situation or a concern with siblings or peers or classmates. We think about those close immediate relatives with the third house. Or this could even be a case of your local area really transforming, such as you literally relocating, okay, from a certain neighborhood to a different one. This could even be the likes of how you move throughout your local city or area in a whole different way. Naturally, with Pluto, there could also be some power struggles that come up. You know, there could be fears that you work through within communication, within conversations. There could be fears amongst neighbors, right? And even within close social networks, with all of the community stuff tied to Aquarius. But naturally, there can also be the overcoming, the resilience, the strength. And you may even really witness and observe just the profoundness of your thoughts, especially if you do find yourself obsessing, really diving into things in an unhealthy, excessive way. Okay. Hopefully, then you can identify these patterns and themes, and then that can welcome greater, so more of a healthier way of viewing things and looking after your mind, basically. Right. Now, what we're going to do is we are going to explore Uranus and Saturn. So, Uranus is going to show the surprises, the unexpected. And then Saturn is going to show what you'll be building, what responsibilities you may have over the next 20 years. But do keep in mind, whenever we look to the Aquarius side of Saturn, there's something quite unique and quite out of the ordinary. There can be some experimentation. Okay, so Uranus is currently hanging out in your sixth house. It has been there for a good while. We'll be there until 2027. So with this part of the transit, this is where we notice these sudden revelations and insights, these epiphanies, these flashes, right? Flashes of insights, actually, to do with the likes of your health, your services, the work you offer, the work you provide. Maybe this is about seeking greater freedom and independence when it comes and wanting to just break free. But then when we consider this, we want to relate it back to Pluto. Just remember, as we go through this journey for you, as we explore your story, we want to relate it back to Pluto in your third house. And we want to think about those themes related to that of communication, even, hey, vehicles, transportation, short distance trips, your local area, this kind of stuff. So perhaps in this regard, this could be about you having and experiencing these sudden insights with relation to certain relationships in your life. And perhaps even there's some detachment involved in this. Perhaps even this stuff is linked to co-workers, right? Co-worker relationships, colleagues, and experiencing certain breakthroughs or seeing where you differ in opinion and then going, hey, that's okay. You believe what you want to believe, but I need to think about my own freedom, my own independence here. Then we move into the seventh. So Uranus will enter Gemini and transit your seventh from 2027 to 2034. Well, Uranus opposing you, just got to speak to Scorpio about this a little bit, but Uranus opposing you, I think, could indicate some surprises and maybe even quite accelerating, exuberating experiences within relationships and partnerships. Now, of course, with Uranus, as I was saying to Scorpio, there can be the sudden endings, right? Those sudden changes happening. So relationships could come to a close out of the blue, or it could be suddenly connecting, relating, sharing. Maybe a lot of this is about community, forming new friendships, new bonds. And with this, of course, being you, Sagittarius, there is an element where there's an element to you where you do tend to explore new territories. You like to try things outside of your comfort zone. So maybe a part of Uranus opposite you is explore the unexpected within relationships and partnerships. You never know what could come up, how you may be surprised. Then from 2034 to 2041, Uranus will enter your eighth. Now with this one, Okay, we could see perhaps some heavier themes, more emotional themes, certain emotional themes that you might want to run away from, not really face, not really deal with. But it could also be facing the truth, actually, being enlightened, being awakened to a certain truth, especially a family matter, thinking about the past, thinking about your memories. Flashbacks could happen. Hey, you know what? For some of you Sagittarians out there, you might decide, I want to go to therapy. I want to go to counseling. I would like to explore my habitual patterns and my emotional habits. You know, what do I do unconsciously? What are my unconscious drives and motivations there? So yeah, we could see some further exploration in this regard, but we could also see perhaps the sudden changes rebellion to do with shared resources, managing other people's money, even thinking about the unexpected with relation to debt. And I'll even say here, which is something that could also be a part of Scorpio's story slightly, but there could be themes here to do with divorce, separation, going your own way. And naturally, this doesn't just have to be a separation when it comes to a marriage, right? This could actually be you separating yourself from or departing from a business relationship, right? Any contracts, agreements, things that you are connected with there, things that you're tied to, so to speak, maybe you would like to change that. So yes, those are just a few different possibilities. But you know, the other thing, just before we move on, remember Uranus can also show up as the unexpected when it comes to that trust and that emotional closeness. Sure, it can also be about detachment. Hopefully healthy detachment can come up in Cancer. Then again, you know, it could be where things are a bit emotionally enmeshed, and then it is about, okay, how can we detach in a healthy way where we're not sort of attached at the hip here? But anyway, we could also see these flashes of insight when it comes to intimacy and trust, that bonding, you know, so coming together. Then from 2041 until 2043, Uranus will enter Leo in the ninth. Honestly, I quite like this for you in a way, because we could really see you exploring, trying things outside of your comfort zone more so, but unexpectedly going on journeys, going on adventures, fun, play, liveliness, spontaneity, you know, travel. There could be a passion, a newfound passion for travel, or hey, a newfound passion for a particular subject that you are learning and you would like to further your understanding with respect to that subject. Maybe even there's something quite exciting and surprising to do with publishing, broadcasting, sharing, teaching, getting your message out there to the world. But you're going to make it lively, and there could be something quite performative and entertaining about the whole thing. Yes. Though, hey, you know what? What also came to my mind there with the ninth house is the unexpected when it comes to legal proceedings. So just keep that in mind. Maybe a part of even Saturn and Uranus through the eighth house for you, right? Could be about making sure that things are in order, that there isn't any, there's no reason for other people maybe to bring up a legal concern with you. But then again, you know, Uranus is always about the unexpected, so you never know. Right, with Uranus being explained, we're going to move on to Saturn. So Saturn is about structure, bringing form, bringing form to things. And there's still this kind of experimental quality with Saturn here, because Saturn does rule Aquarius. And I also want to say, before we move any further, that remember overlaps. there are going to be overlaps between the dates just because of retrogrades, things like that. I mean, for example, Saturn in Pisces will make a sextile to Uranus in Taurus. And then a while after that, well, not too long after that, Saturn in Aries will make that sextile to Uranus in Gemini. So just remember those overlaps when it comes to the dates. Look into those for yourself. Let's get to this then. Saturn has been hanging out in your fourth house since 2023 and will be there until 2026. So there is something here about you feeling somewhat limited or restricted within your home, within your family. And I'm gonna be honest about this one. You know, it could be that this feels really frustrating for you. Think about that square aspect to you, Sagittarius, right? So you're just asked, I think, here to be somewhat organized and responsible when it comes to your home life, your family life, to show some kind of discipline and dedication, but at the same time to draw from your own spiritual insights and your intuition throughout the process. Maybe rest is really a big part of this too. Then from 2026 to 2028, we have Saturn in your fifth. So we could see this structuring, building kind of energy happening when it comes to your children. Maybe this is about how you discipline your children, for instance. Maybe this is about trying to understand the best way forward for your children in certain terms of the life that you want to build for them for the long haul. Or this could even be about your passions and your goals. So goals, especially related to your creativity, sports could also be a part of this, adventure, exploration, trying out new things. So I think Saturn here says show discipline, and you just might find that things could really change here when it comes to a certain creative project of yours or a hobby. Then as we move into 2028 to 2030, Saturn will enter your sixth. So again, remember overlaps, but what I want to say about this is think about how Uranus has been in your sixth house for the past number of years. So by the time we get to Saturn in Taurus, you will have learned, hopefully, a few lessons about the unpredictable, the unexpected, regarding your work and your services and your health. Hey, your health as well is very much part of this. So by the time Saturn then enters the sixth house from 2028 to 2030, you can maybe start to see, okay, how does this feel? Really paying attention to the body. Can you slow down? Can you manage your time a bit more effectively there? Can you maybe move in a slow, gradual way where you follow things through till completion when it comes to your work? Or, you know, maybe this is about reaching out for some kind of professional help when it comes to your health, right? Especially this could be your physical health, right? Maybe even this is some sort of guidance or assistance with respect to your diet or your fitness levels. Then we move into 2030 to 2032. Saturn will oppose you. Now, with Saturn opposing you in the seventh, there could be something about your relationships that says, show commitment, show integrity, take this seriously, but hey, maybe not too seriously with Gemini, still show some kind of lightheartedness, I get it. Maybe a part of it too is having the conversation, okay? I think that this could be where communication is so important within your relationships. So what I want to say from this point is, oh, and just even to further say, this could be the ways in which you communicate with your significant other, with your spouse, but this could also be related to that of business deals, contracts, agreements, to make sure that you are considering the long haul and to be mindful, I suppose, about what you're committing yourself to. But then again, it could also be about solidifying plans with a significant other or when it comes to a business. So I just wanted to say that. But still, I want to mention Saturn and Uranus will conjunct in Gemini at the end of June 2032. So this will happen in your seventh house. So this is going to start a whole new cycle, a 45-year cycle, Sagittarius, within your seventh house, communicating then things like, okay, it's time to consider the long haul here within our relationship, within our partnership, but maybe there are some changes. Maybe there are things that we haven't explored yet. Perhaps it's about innovation, exploring those alternatives there, and even showcasing this excitement, this, oh, things could really change for us. Whenever we come together, we find that things can be quite exciting. And maybe too, we could see conversation breakthroughs, breakthroughs, mindset breakthroughs. Now, again, we want to think about how this energy could show up more in a business setting. But hey, you know what? This could even be about your shadow, your unconscious, you coming to terms with your own mindset and how you could very well shift. You know, your mindset could shift massively. And that could even be enough for you to change the trajectory of your life at that point. Okay, from 2032 until 2035, Saturn will be in your eighth. Right, okay, so this is also where we can see some tension or struggle and limitation when we think about the ways in which you trust and bond. And vulnerability could really come up here. I think, you know, with the parts of Pluto in Aquarius, right, where there is Uranus and Saturn in the eighth, if we bring it back slightly to Pluto in Aquarius, I think these periods could be about your psychology. Okay, this is about inner insights, getting a look at why do I do certain things? Why am I reacting like this? Why am I behaving like this? What is it about this situation that triggers me? What is it about this situation that sets me off so much? Why do I care so much? Why am I attached to this situation? Right? So there could be some emotional things that feel actually very intense and it's, ooh. But I think Pluto in Aquarius serves as a reminder that you can communicate and you can try to figure out why you do the things you do. So it could be quite the psychological journey. And then as we move into 2035 to 2037, Saturn will enter the ninth. So perhaps with this part, there is greater authority, greater respect, greater determination when it comes to the things that you share with the world. You being admired, recognized for your publications, for what you showcase in this way, what you broadcast. And again, you know, there could be something performative and even quite fun and playful about the whole experience. Naturally, with Saturn and Leo, you know, there can be themes of not feeling good enough at times, you know, not feeling the most confident or being quite worried, you know, about, oh, how's my art going to be perceived, or how's my creativity going to be seen by other people? This kind of stuff can happen. But still, it is about that hard work that you put in. And then from you showing that dedication, you could very well be rewarded. From 2037 then to 2039, we've got Saturn in the 10th. Quite an interesting journey, I think, for you here, Sagittarius. We're going all the way around back to the first, well, the 12th, but Saturn, of course, in this way will enter your sign at the very end. But yeah, we're coming you know, up to this above the horizon point and then all the way to the 12th. But anyway, with Saturn in Virgo, we see here the focus being more about your professional life. This is about the services you provide with the public. This could even be about you being recognized for your company contributions, for how you show up consistently when it comes to your professional lives. Again, I do acknowledge that we could all be at other stages. You know, it depends on what stage you're at in your life throughout this transit. So even when we think about retirement, for instance, this could just be you getting a really good pension, you know, or this could be about you being able to reflect on your life's work and the services that you have provided, how you've helped other people, how you've been of service to other people. And then there's that recognition. There's that greater recognition on your part. And you feel even more like, you know, I worked hard there. Acknowledging your wins, acknowledging your successes, really, here, Sagittarius. Then as we move into 2039 to 2041, Saturn will be in the 11th. So with this part, we could see you really making an impact or just influencing your communities and your teams, or maybe it's greater recognition for how you have helped shape other people's lives and people maybe giving to you or wanting to be around you and to collaborate more strongly. Maybe this is even about the efforts that you put in and the dedication you show when it comes to volunteering or charity work and just making a difference within the world, right? Your group participations. And then we close off here, Pluto in Aquarius, with Saturn entering your 12th. Well, so this will be from 2041 to 2043, just to close the transit. Saturn coming into the 12th, especially with Pluto already in the third, you know, there could be something here about you finalizing a situation. Indeed, there could be a chapter closing. There could be something coming to an end, because the 12th house often looks at endings, and Scorpio itself is a sign of loss and transformation. So I wonder if such matters will be somehow linked to that of your finances, your resources, your valuables, your physical security or communication there, what you're studying, what you're learning, essentially. But then there's also going to be that spiritual part of it, you know? There's the spiritual insights, the spiritual wisdom that you can gain or that come through within their own time. And then because of that, you can carry those sort of lessons into the next chapter, into the next part of your journey. Think of it this way. For you, Saturn will then enter your sign after Scorpio. And then the unique thing actually will be at the very end of that is Pluto will be in Pisces. So Pluto will be in your fourth. So we could see significant new beginnings there, which will also be linked to that of your family and your home more toward the end of the transit. But essentially here, basically, we're noticing those ending patterns and themes, and a lot of it could even be psychological transformations, transforming from the inside out, coming to terms with your own compulsions and anything that hinders you, you know, anything that blocks you from your progress. Self-undoing, right, with the 12th house. But then, of course, just remember here, Sagittarius, that it's about taking the information from today and applying it to that of your mindset, communication, and also those relationships that we mentioned earlier. So siblings, cousins, those close, immediate environment, relationships there, just your immediate environment in general there. Thank you so much, Sagittarius. And now what we're going to do is we are going to move on to Capricorn. Okay, Capricorn, what is in store for you as Pluto transits your second house over the next 20 years? Well, something I want to mention for you is it's a pretty unique thing. Well, you could also argue that Sagittarius is sort of similar to you. But what I want to say here is Pluto will not be touching you anymore, so to speak, right? Pluto's leaving your sign. But then also your chart ruler, Saturn, whilst yes, the chart ruler Saturn through those signs will have something to tell you about your life path, but it won't be in your sign at all whilst Pluto is in your second house. So what's coming through for you perhaps is you can breathe, right? You can breathe slightly. And I get it. There's still going to be things like other planets traveling through your sign. I mean, we'll have Mars entering your sign. I think that will not be for a good while though, because we do have the Mars retrograde coming up in Cancer. There could be oppositions, of course, with any planets that you have there, but I digress, okay? There's still something here about the release of struggle, the release of tension, and coming out of this period anew, reborn. And you know what's also coming to my mind here? And I could just spend a good bit of time with you here, Capricorn. But one of you viewers out there, right? One of you mentioned how with Pluto leaving your sign, there's some grief coming up, actually. There's some feelings of loss, right? And I guess this makes sense, right? It makes sense that when we say goodbye to an era, to a transit, especially with Pluto being in your sign for so long, I'm sure it can bring up a lot of grief and sadness and this sort of feeling of things are never going to be the same, you know? So it's an interesting one because as one door opens, another closes. And whilst there can be excitement about a new opportunity, about that door opening, there can also be the sadness related to the other door closing. So I just wanted to acknowledge that a little bit. If it is that you are someone with significant Capricorn placements and you're feeling this way. And I want to say thank you so much to the viewer who commented that. It really opened my mind. So I appreciate you for saying that. Okay, let's now get into it, shall we? Pluto will enter Aquarius, and we have noticed the tasters, of course, over the past couple of years, but with this transit throughout your second house over the next 20 years, we're really going to see you stepping into your power when it comes to your finances and your security. And with you even being this earth sign, right, this cardinal earth sign, you're all about building and you don't take the shortcuts. And I would also argue if you are Capricorn and you tend to take shortcuts, you are redirected pretty quickly, right? Karma kind of hits you in the face, so to speak. There is a lesson. So I think that with Pluto traveling through the second house, there could be some significant shifts and insights related to your financial growth and what you want to achieve there. Of course, for the long haul, right? For the long haul, I would say, given how it is you, Capricorn, and you could be surprised. You could really be surprised by what comes up. And you could be even surprised by your skill set and what you have to offer the world. Maybe a lot of this is community driven. It's community driven. It's about others. It's about the collective, your humanity, wanting to serve in some way, shape, or form. And perhaps as well, there's something quite inventive about this next era, this next chapter for you, where you could experiment, you could try all different things for some ideas, right? To kind of gain new perspectives. There's just a lot of uniqueness and differentness coming up here for you when it comes to your streams of income, even your values. You could be surprised by how your values shift and change based on your experiences over the next coming years, Capricorn. Now, naturally with Pluto, yes, there could also be losses, okay? There could be certain financial means, methods, security, right? Security matters that can create this urgency, this emergency feeling. And yeah, there could also be then things ending with Pluto through the second. But I also want to look at this as Pluto indicates the rebirth, rebirths and overcoming particular challenges that life throws at you when it comes to the physical stuff, the practical stuff here. Okay. Oh, which, by the way, your self-worth, your self-esteem with the second house. So maybe for many Capricorns out there, it's about saying, yeah, there are certain parts of me, certain traits, certain qualities that other people may deem as weird or unusual or out of the ordinary. But you know what? I don't care. I'm going to be me. You know, there could just be this personal growth, this personal empowerment related to your self-worth. Okay, what we're going to do then is we're going to explore Uranus. And then we'll move on to Saturn, your chart ruler, right? So Uranus is going to show us the shocks and the unpredictable, the unexpected throughout your journey. And then Saturn naturally is going to be all about structure and what you wish to build for the long haul. But just remember, because Saturn is one of the dispositors of Pluto in this case, I also see this as there being an element of thinking outside of the box and originality, experimentation. Okay, so Uranus has been hanging out in your fifth house for a good number of years. Will continue to be there until 2027. So what we could see then for you, especially with Pluto entering the second, is this shock factor, this excitement even, when it comes to your self-expression and your creativity. There's just something here about your creative edge. What is it about you that makes you stand out, you know, to stand out from the crowd with respect to your creative projects and how such things can also show up as how you make a living? They are linked somehow to your finances and your earnings. Then again, this could simply be about you getting in touch with the things that, well, bring you joy. They make you smile. they're happy. They're happy experiences where you get to feel free and you get to be quite curious about what the future holds there. There's just this non-conforming, this breaking free type of energy happening when it comes to the things that light you up. Then we move to 2027 to 2034. So Uranus will be in your sixth house. So this is where we're really going to see a lot of innovation happening, actually, when it comes to your work and your services, and a lot of learning. My goodness, a lot of courses and studying and researching happening with respect to your work. And perhaps even a big part of this is seeing that there are other people to collaborate with, right? We think about how Pluto will be in the second, Uranus will be in the sixth. So there will be a bit of a trine between these planets. And so we could see these sudden changes, these surprises to do with your working life, your routines, your habits. But there's also this element, I think, of togetherness and unity and just joining with others, perhaps as a way to make the world a better place or as a way to inform others about certain issues in the world, concerns you have. And, you know, maybe a big part of this too is being surprised by how you can switch things up on a day-to-day basis and how it's this whole thing of every day's a school day and you never know what tomorrow might bring. So yeah, we could just see this changeable energy happening, which again, sudden changes, very unexpected, happening when it comes to your everyday routines and schedules. Then we come to 2034 until 2041. Uranus will be opposing you in the seventh there. So Uranus is kind of, it will sit opposite you, and it will be kind of waving its hand at you, so to speak, saying, hey, how would you like to maybe engage in something different, something new when it comes to relationships and partnerships? Maybe these relationships and partnerships are especially family related, or there's some kind of emotional connection involved, or maybe this is about caregiving and showing support or wanting to help your fellow man in some way, shape, or form. But similar to what I've said to other signs, there could also be this element of relationships suddenly, abruptly beginning. And it could be this whole whirlwind of emotion, but it could also be things, relationships and partnerships suddenly coming to a close and you going your separate ways. There could be this detachment, this distancing energy happening as well when it comes to relationships and partnerships. Then we come to 2041 until 2043. And so Uranus will be in the eighth house. Now, with this one, quite an interesting one, I think, because as we come to the end of Pluto being in Aquarius, we have this Uranus influence in the opposite house. So maybe you could be surprised by unpredictable repayments, thinking about loans and debts that get repaid there, or the payment plans may not go according to plan even. Hey, just be cautious with this one, because this could be a case of debt just suddenly falling on your lap. Just maybe use a bit of discernment. Then again, hey, this could also be about child-related matters. Thinking about the inner child, perhaps, those insights that could come up, and considering even with Leo in the eighth house for you, Capricorn, it almost feels like a big part of your self-expression is hidden or it's difficult to access. So Uranus coming into this position could be where the box is just opened. And it can be wild and unruly, and you may find that hard to really contain. So we could look at this as some kind of transformative energy, you know, when it comes to your creativity and play and spontaneity. And then the other thing even to consider with this is children could really come into the equation here. Maybe it's children that sort of bring out these parts of you, if you will, or it's love and it's romance. It's these types of things. Okay, so we've explored Uranus, which I just want to say here, overlaps. Remember overlaps with the dates. Look more into those dates for yourself. But, you know, for example, I just want to say there is the Saturn in Pisces, Uranus in Taurus sextile, and then there's also the Saturn in Aries and Uranus in Gemini sextile. But as I say, yes, look into the overlaps and the dates because retrogrades will happen. Just look into those things for yourself. Now, we are going to move on to Saturn, your chart ruler. What are you going to be building? Okay. We want to think about how Saturn is currently in your third house. So there's a lot of ambition and integrity and discipline happening with respect to how you deliver information, how you communicate a message strongly, and how you study, you know, wanting to maybe be a professional, explore some area of expertise. But you also want to think about how there's an element of spiritual insight with Pisces. And perhaps even a part of this is your intuition being very much heightened and activated and in a way guiding you when it comes to the likes of business or your career or your long-term goals there. There's a lot of maturity happening, spiritual maturity, emotional maturity with Saturn in Pisces in the third. So this will be up until about 2026. Again, remember overlaps, okay, because there will be a bit of a dip where Saturn and Neptune enter Aries throughout 2025, but they will retrograde. So just remember that. Then we move on to 2026 until 2028. Your chart ruler will be in the fourth. So there will be this element of building and creating structure and being responsible when it comes to your family life, your living situation. And this could very well look like many of you Capricorns deciding, right, okay, it is time to raise a family, or it's time to set down roots, it's time to buy a home, or it's time to move, to leave this particular living situation and be more independent. I want to build a life for myself. I want to think about my own plans, my own goals there. And this could also then be about taking responsibility of family members. The thing about this, I just want to say, is we could all be at a very different stage of our lives as we explore the next 20 years. So it really does depend on where you're at, how old you are, and everything else. But yes, Saturn in the fourth could be about you taking responsibility for certain family members, and really attending to their needs, maybe because you are asked to be a bit of a caregiver, so to speak. Then we move on to 2028 until 2030, Saturn will be in the fifth in Taurus. So this could really be where a child does come into the equation, or it's that you strongly think about how you discipline any children you have, or you thinking about how you teach them, you know, teaching them healthy boundaries, for example, and how it is that you support your children. Plus, for you Capricorn, this could be a case of you putting a lot of effort into that of your creative projects. Just taking your time, okay, considering slow and steady wins the race, following things through until completion there with Taurus. Maybe a part of it too is to slow down a bit and to appreciate where you're at. You could be reaping rewards actually here with respect to your creativity in some way, shape, or form. Just try to not be so hard on yourself either with that Saturn influence through the fifth. Then we come to 2030 until 2032, and Saturn will be in the sixth for you there. So we could see then greater authority, greater integrity and responsibility when it comes to your workload. Thinking about your productivity levels, your stress levels too. Be quite mindful of that, I would say. You know, it could be that things are a bit chaotic, or they do feel somewhat overwhelming, and it is you, Capricorn, and you do tend to be quite ambitious. You can be overachievers, high achievers. So hopefully, you know, with your chart ruler being in the sixth and Uranus also being there, there can be this kind of freedom that you experience, this breaking away, this breakthrough sort of energy. But do also remember as well that the sixth house is, it rules health. So, you know, with this one, and I don't want to create some sort of fear mongering or anything like that, but with Gemini, you know, there could be some concerns there to do with your mental health, your mental well-being. So just maybe this is also where it would behoove you to take care of yourself and to consider how much you may or may not be taking on. But here's the other thing. There will be the Saturn-Uranus conjunction, actually, at the end of June 2032 in Gemini, in your sixth house, Capricorn. So this is where we're going to see this new cycle, this new 45-year cycle being ushered in for you. To do with what? To do with your health, to do with the day-to-day and your schedules and your overall responsibilities. I think there will be a part of it that says, okay, this is my responsibility. This is about me being disciplined here. But there will also be the other side with Uranus highlighting, okay, but what about some changes we can make? How can we maybe explore alternatives? How can we move past some limitations here? Maybe breakthroughs could happen. And I would even say here with Gemini, and especially with, again, Pluto being in the second house in Aquarius, this stuff will involve teams. It will involve the group in some way, shape, or form. Realizing that it's not just you that's in it. There are other members here that you can reach out for advice. And yeah, there's just that team work quality. Even just being quite creative, thinking in a more flexible way, okay? And seeing which changes you can make, such as, you know, delegating, right? To be able to delegate, or to be able to ask for advice by just communicating, right? Communicating with others. Okay, so from 2032 until 2035, Saturn then will enter your seventh. So with Saturn in the seventh here in Cancer, there could be this quality. Well, think about how your chart ruler will be opposing you. There could be this quality of, hey, you know what? I'm giving up some kind of control, and I've just got to trust that my relationships or my partners, my spouse, whoever it may be, you know, that they have got it. I can't manage this situation. I can't, no matter how hard I try, I cannot control other people, and I need to realize that. It's not my responsibility here to clean up this mess and that mess and do this and do that. I think a lot of stuff to do with responsibility will come up, right? Keep in mind that I think with Pluto traveling through your sign over the past 16 years, already you've been experiencing these renewals and these transformations related to responsibility and thinking about your own personal responsibilities and your own personal discipline and your life path and your aims and your goals. So by that point, you know, there could be just this part of it where others reflect back at you just what you're not willing to tolerate and how you can have firmer, healthier boundaries. And at the same time, still showing love. There could be this tough love influence. Now, before we go any further, I just want to take this a step back. And I want to explain that we previously talked about Uranus in Taurus, right? Uranus in Taurus will be there until 2027. So there will be all of that unpredictable stuff still going on, right? When it comes to your hobbies, your creativity, children, pleasure, play, fun. But you see, Saturn from 2028 until 2030 will follow that same path and will give you an opportunity to rebuild, to reorganize a few things, So I think that's where we're going to see that foundation stuff, the stronger foundations that you can build, and then you work from there. Okay, I just wanted to mention that. Moving on to Leo. So from 2035 until 2037, Saturn will enter your eighth. Now this part of Pluto and Aquarius, especially with the opposition to Pluto, this one could be quite tough, I'm going to say here. It could be emotionally tough. It could be tough in terms of finances. There could be some tension there when it comes to finances, struggle. Maybe in this way, you know, there's the element of those losses, right? There could be some financial losses or practical things may fall through. Then again, this could be more of an emotional thing, a psychological thing. It just could feel a bit more stressful or burdensome in some ways, I think, for you Capricorn around that time. Thinking about ownership, thinking about your security, and even vulnerability and intimacy. So there could also be those elements of just emotions just pouring and pouring and pouring. And again, this is not to create fear. It's just more about this is what we see in the astrology with this opposition, right? With Saturn opposite Pluto, you know, in these houses, this does tend to create some kind of tension and difficulty and challenge. So it's just to really prepare you in some ways. But, you know, this could even just be a case of you gaining some sort of insights from professionals, right? A professional who can help you with your own psychology, so to speak, help you work through anything that does come up that is difficult to process there. Okay, so from 2037 until 2039, Saturn will be in the ninth house. So with your chart ruler being in the ninth house here, Capricorn, we could see you putting plans in place when it comes to travel, right? Long distance travel, you know, even think about it this way, after perhaps what will feel like a pretty challenging period, which I'm not suggesting is going to involve the whole entire, you know, time of Saturn in the eighth house, just to say, but after a somewhat challenging period with Saturn in the eighth, you come to Saturn in the ninth, and perhaps there is a part of it where you go, you know what, I need a holiday. I'm going to go on vacation. I'm going to look after myself. Just taking care of yourself, slowing down enough to take care of yourself, to take care of your mind and your body. Could be some sort of travel experience that is very much health conscious. Or, you know, this could be about you deciding, I really want to help people in a different way. You know, I want to become a nurse or a doctor. I want to get into the medical field. You know, these are just examples, but you could just explore that in terms of higher education for yourself in some way, shape, or form, okay? Then we come to 2039 until 2041, and Saturn will be in the 10th. Oh, Saturn, of course, in the 10th, exalted in Libra. So there could be something quite committing, and there's this element of longevity when it comes to business, your professional lives. Perhaps this stuff will involve your spouse, a business partner, a kind of deal or an agreement. Hey, this could be a certain contract or an agreement that you sign, and it sets you up in such a huge way. Or this could be about you getting to that point and looking back on the past, however many years since Pluto entered Aquarius, and going, wow, like I've really, really worked hard. I went from this third house part of my life all the way to this 10th house, and I've put in the work. I've done the thing. I've made the effort. And so you can look back on your successes and you can give appreciation. But, you know, still with Saturn in the 10th, still going to require some kind of effort and dedication on your part. Then we come to the end of Pluto in Aquarius, and Saturn will be in Scorpio in the 11th house from 2041 until 2043. So this could actually be where you have a bit of a clear out, so to speak, honestly, a bit of a clear out when it comes to friendships or teams or groups and organizations and companies, right? So you kind of think, I don't feel it anymore, or, oh, that was intense, wasn't it? Or I'm not really going to accept that kind of power struggle. That's weird. I don't appreciate any manipulative tactics there. We could just see this clear out, this kind of purge. I've already had Pluto in my sign for such a long time, and that I'm just not putting up with from other people. I'm just not doing it. Yeah, so that could be a good period of real empowerment and just this badass energy, I think, when it comes to grips. But then again, you know what? It could also be an element of compassion and really showing empathy toward your communities and people who may need support, you know, people who may be vulnerable. And so you make the effort to, again, make the world a better place. Now, remember that this journey, you want to think about how the journey is linked to that of your resources and your finances and your security and ownership and all that stuff, stocks and bonds, investments, here with the second house. Capricorn, hey, thank you so much. I feel like I need to say more just as a way to give a nod to how Pluto has been in your sign for so long, but I wish you the best of luck with this transit. Now we move on to Aquarius. All right, Aquarius, dun dun dun, dun 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 dun. It is your time, your time. You're up, Aquarius, you're up. Okay, so we have Pluto transiting your first house over the next 20 years. And here's something I also just want to mention here. Okay, so even Saturn, one of your chart rulers, Saturn, will move through this. It will go from the second house all the way to the 10th. So this is going to be quite the journey for you. Very interesting. I'm really excited and hyped for many of you Aquarians out there. I hope you are. I hope this isn't a transit that's, you know, full of fear, and that's okay too. You know, if you do feel quite fearful or apprehensive and worrisome, it's completely normal. Especially because Pluto can be ruthless at times. It can show no mercy. But let's explore. Let's explore you. So with Pluto transiting your first house, we could really see things changing for you in magnanimous ways when it comes to your life path. This could be where the future you thought you would build or create, things just change so rapidly. And it feels very fast. You know, there's this accelerating energy. There's this electrifying energy, even when it comes to you. Perhaps even your intuition is going to be on fire. I mean, lit up, huge. And there's this intensity even when it comes to, well, what you want in life. There could be what even feels like an obsessiveness. This, I will not stop until I get what I want. It could be that big for you. Or maybe even a part of this is coming to terms with your own compulsions, right? Your unconscious drives, what motivates you unconsciously. And we could argue that with Pluto transiting your 12th house over the past 16 years, right? We've explored that, you know, we explored this in the Pluto and Capricorn story video. So you could argue that you've already been doing a lot of that inner work and getting in touch with why you do the things you do and what hinders your progress, you know, the unconscious drives that get in the way, that block you, that limit you. But I still think there is an element here of Pluto in your sign where there can be certain levels of resistance or trying to become more consciously connected with the things that you're not fully aware of, to integrate the shadow so that you can move with greater awareness, to be a bit more conscious about your path, and to ask yourself the why. Why am I doing this? Why do I want this? What is my reason behind this? And we could also see, of course, with Pluto in your sign, the transformations and the renewals tied to, well, firstly, your appearance. So this could actually be for you, for many of you Aquarians, having a child, raising a family. This could also be a case of you changing your body in quite a huge way, right? Whether this be losing a ton of weight, getting really, really fit and being very active, just as examples. This could also be a case of maybe getting loads of tattoos or piercings, you know, whatever it is for you. There's just something here about transforming your body, your physical appearance. But this could also be in terms of your vibe, the vibe you give off. We could see, well, on one hand, less tolerance for BS, honestly. But on another way to look at this is we could see this greater compassion and maybe a part of your strong feelings and being compassionate towards others, trying to really engage and see where they're coming from. Maybe these things stem from a loss or grief. They stem from emotions where you have experienced hurt and pain. Maybe even there's a part of this where you go, I am going to carry forward the lessons that Pluto and Capricorn taught me. I'm going to bring them forward. So what we want to do now is explore Uranus. Uranus and Saturn are your chart rulers, and they are also, of course, the dispositor of Pluto in this case. Even just want to say here, there's so much to be said about you overcoming your fears. Or maybe a better way to put this is to not let your fears consume you. This is what I'm getting from this energy. And I'm thinking here about certain experiences I've had lately. And it's interesting to see the connections, the light bulb moments, the aha moments when it comes to Aquarius, right? And I do have Aquarius planets, basically. Okay, let's explore this. Uranus. Uranus is currently hanging out in your fourth house and will be there until 2027. So a lot of family stuff has been happening for you, Aquarius, over the past number of years. A lot of family chaos and drama and the unexpected. Oh, can you just catch a break? I know, right? Maybe even a part of this is security shakeups, living situation, home-related shakeups. I mean, really, I have to move again. It's so interesting to me because I have moved a lot, a lot over the past number of years. Maybe you just want a breather, right? Maybe you're like, okay, I get that I'm all about change and the new, but I would just like a bit of stability in my life. Perhaps even in this respect, patience. Patience has been a virtue. You've been reminded of patience and just to ride it out, you know, to maybe accept that there's only so much you can control, especially when you think about your living situation and your physical security. There's only so much you can control. And especially too, think about that with respect to family members. Mm-hmm. Maybe just having this more detached approach of, I don't need to deal with that. I can step away from that. I need to think about myself. I'm not giving into the drama. So this is what I'm getting from this, especially the Pluto in combination here with Uranus. Pluto is sort of saying, recognize those cycles. Recognize the cycles that you can break and the work, the inner work that you've already done. Don't give in. You don't have to do that. Now, moving on to Uranus entering your fifth house from 2027 until 2034. So what could come up here is the unexpected, the unexpected, the surprises when it comes to children, whether this be literally having a child or this be just the unexpected related to how your children act and the way they communicate. You know, there could be some significant shifts there when it comes to your children. Maybe it's like, what, you know, my child is really curious about this thing and they want to learn about this and that. And maybe as the Aquarius, you're like, whoa, yeah, okay, let's do it. You know, there just could be this, this excitement related to learning coming from your children, or of course, this could be you. So with children to the side for a moment, this could also be about you. So thinking about your hobbies, games you play, the fun, spontaneity. I'm getting this electrifying energy, this intuitive energy where you want to learn more and you want to get into this thing and that thing. And there's flexibility, there's freedom. Freedom, okay. Maybe there's a greater desire to want to have fun with your partner and to switch things up, okay, to make it quite spicy. So yeah, this could be quite a lighthearted energy. We think about this in combination with Pluto, right, with that trine energy. Indeed, things could just feel a bit more lighter when it comes to love and romance, children, your hobbies, and when it comes to the things you enjoy. Okay, then we come to 2034 until 2041. Uranus will enter your sixth. So this could actually be where there are surprises and sudden changes, the unexpected, with relation to your everyday, your schedules, your daily habits. Maybe a part of this is really having to ride the waves of emotion in some ways. Or this is about the support and the care that you offer within the work that you do or the services you provide. But there is still that shock factor and not really knowing what to expect. And maybe even a part of this is your coworkers or your colleagues coming to you and them showing empathy, them showing support. Maybe even this is about teamwork and really banding together, right? To band together and to show support within the workplace, to get together with like minds, to be really engaged in interesting conversations. And there's that feeling of, I belong here. I belong here. I feel supported here. But again, all very sudden and unexpected with Uranus. Then we come to the end of Pluto and Aquarius, right? The end of Pluto in your sign. Uranus will oppose you actually from 2041 until 2043 in Leo. So I think with this particular one, with one of your chart rulers opposite you, maybe a part of this is you kind of observing the eccentricities and the possible aloofness in other people, right? You think about how Uranus will be opposite you and what will be reflected back at you is perhaps, yes, your own aloofness, your own detachment, but maybe there's something quite playful about that, right? To play around with new ideas and to be creative about these matters in a way where you want to create, right? You want to create something, you want to get into a new project. Maybe you can do that within a partnership, within a relationship, perhaps even love and romance, bring this unexpected energy, and you just might be caught off guard by affection, by the spontaneity that comes up when it comes to relationships, so to speak there. Interesting. Okay, now what we're going to do is we're going to explore Saturn. And with Saturn being one of the dispositors of Pluto, one of your rulers, with you, Aquarius, there's always going to be this experimental sort of energy and trying out new things, differentness, uniqueness, all of that good stuff. So remember that as we go through. And I also just want to say, before we move on, remember the overlaps. There are overlaps when it comes to these dates. Just look more into the dates for yourself, right? Remember retrogrades, for instance. I mean, we're going to have the Saturn in Pisces, sextile Uranus in Taurus, and then also the Saturn in Aries, sextile Uranus in Gemini, as examples, more at the beginning of Pluto in Aquarius. So yes, remember overlaps when it comes to the dates. Okay, Saturn is currently hanging out in your second house, has been there since 2023, will be there until 2026. Again, remember overlaps, because both Saturn and Neptune will enter Aries in 2025, but I digress. What we are noticing here for you, Aquarius, yes, this, oh my goodness, whenever I reflect on this, when will it move? Things are so delayed. When are things going to change when it comes to finances and your resources and your earnings? But what this also indicates is inner faith. Inner faith, trust, trusting in God, trusting in the universe, in the creator, trusting that things are going to flow, things are working out in your favor, but you just can't see them. You can't see the behind the scenes stuff that is going on. Breathe out, okay? But I would even argue with this, that this has been a good opportunity for you to, in a way, see how aligned you are, especially spiritually, with your skills and your talents, right? What speaks to you? What feels right? A lot of this is about feeling and intuition and spiritual insight. Then we come to 2026 until 2028, and then Saturn will be in the third. So this could actually be where, in a communicative setting, right, thinking about socializing, reporting, educating, learning as well even, but we could see you being somewhat of an authority, taking the lead, being courageous, being a bit of a daredevil. We also want to think about how Neptune will play a role too, I suppose. You know, so Neptune will be with Saturn for a period of time. And so Neptune can indicate this imagination, this compassion, this healing energy, this therapeutic energy, maybe being very giving and offering kindness, just showing kindness. Perhaps there will be another video about Neptune and Pisces. I'm not sure, but or Neptune in Aries as well. But anyway, I digress. Just remember that with Saturn also in Aries, there's still that Pisces, that Neptune theme, the Neptune theme. Then we move on to 2028 until 2030. Saturn will be in your fourth. So think of it like this. This is what I've been doing for the other signs. Uranus has been traveling through your fourth house and really ushering in all of these unexpected shifts to do with your family life, your living situation, all that good stuff, your emotional needs, your emotional attachments. But then Uranus will leave, and then Saturn, your other chart ruler, will enter. And this will be a good opportunity for you to maybe realign yourself, so to speak, when it comes to family values or when it comes to substance with respect to your living situation, quality, desire, pleasure, Maybe this is even about greater sensuality that can be experienced within the home. Maybe this is even about just thinking about the long haul, right? The long haul when it comes to family and resources and that physical security stuff and just how you can provide for your loved ones. There's more of a steadiness, okay? Hopefully this is more of a steadiness. I also get that there will be a bit of that square between Saturn and Pluto, okay? And so maybe that could be where there's some tension or challenge. Maybe more on that at another stage. We're not going to get into all of the different aspects here. But yes, that aspect maybe could come with this, with its identity challenges, its family challenges. So I'll just say that. But then we move on to Gemini. So from 2030 until 2032, Saturn will be in your fifth. So with Saturn in the fifth, we're going to maybe see this greater authority and responsibility happening with respect to, okay, your children, your hobbies, your forms of recreation, enjoyment, entertainment, these areas. Maybe just being a bit more focused, really trying to concentrate, trying to study and learn and improve in some ways, you know, maybe to try and improve when it comes to how you parent, as an example, or to maybe educate yourself a bit more when it comes to a certain hobby of yours. And so the thing about this is Saturn will conjunct Uranus at the end of June 2032 in Gemini, so in your fifth house. So what we're going to see is this new 45-year cycle for you when it comes to the likes of enjoyment and entertainment and the things that you just genuinely enjoy doing, right? It's those things that light you up, those things that just make you happy. So a part of this, I think, will be, okay, I need to focus. I need to concentrate. But another part will be originality, fresh ideas, exploring alternatives. This could be something that you want to invent. And it's perhaps, of course, then creative, right? A creative pursuit where there's a lot of innovation happening there. You want to do something new. And maybe you even want to offer that to the world. Then we move on to 2032 until 2035. And so Saturn will be in your sixth. So we're going to see during that period, this stability, this structure, longevity with respect to your work and your everyday habits and routines. Maybe it is about taking things a little bit slower, being a bit more focused on, okay, how does this actually feel? You know, moving through the motions, but maybe at the same time, this is about how you can offer your support in practical, reasonable ways, you know, to show compassion and empathy, but to physically do that, right? To do that through some service you offer, for example, you know, or maybe this will be about you taking greater care of yourself, right? A lot of self-care, pouring into yourself, remembering your health, okay? Your health, to slow it down a bit so that you feel a bit more aligned. Then we come to 2035 until 2037. Saturn will oppose you. Saturn in the opposite sign, of course, could be that you observe then in others people's own limitations or how they might experience confidence blockages, or even you might be a witness to possible creativity projections or childish projections. Maybe as well, this could be a good opportunity for you to go into business. You know, there could be some sort of creative business, or this could be about leadership, confidence, and just being confident in a business matter, making certain agreements, right? Agreeing to a certain plan. Again, this plan could involve another person with Saturn in the seventh. but there's still that element of, I would say, even fun and play, and perhaps even thinking about that, the artistic side of Leo. And hey, this could also be a case of you clashing a bit, you know, maybe clashing a bit when it comes to other people's views, so to speak, maybe because the other person involved is a bit more concerned about themselves. Yeah, so there could be a bit of a power struggle there. Keep in mind how Saturn will oppose Pluto in the first. Again, perhaps we will go more in detail into those aspects in the years to come. My goodness, that's not until, what, like 10, 13, 12 years away? Yeah. I'm going way, way into the future here. Anyway, then we move on to Saturn in your eighth house from 2037 until 2039. So this is where we may see some struggle to do with overthinking or perfectionism, just kind of rearing its head, just creeping in and trying to maybe sabotage you slightly. But it could also be a case of you putting a plan in place when it comes to your psychology, when it comes to exploring your unconscious. Or, you know, this could even be a case of some of you Aquarians out there wanting to be a psychotherapist, or, you know, to think about psychoanalysis there and how that could be a bit of a service for you. And maybe that is a bit of a trajectory that you take over the next coming years, right? So just on that note, I do get that we're all at different stages as we explore, right? We're at different stages of our lives as we explore the next 20 years. So as I say, it could be a case of you wanting to become some sort of authority or professional when it comes to psychology. But then this could also be really refining your skills when it comes to occult-like practices, even astrology, right? Astrology and what you offer there. Then we come to 2039 until 2041, and Saturn will be in your ninth. So this could be a really great time period for you to explore, to roam, to get curious about what's out there in the world, and doing that, right? So thinking about long distance travel, doing that with someone else, whether this be your significant other, your spouse, your lover, your friend, your colleague, so your business partner. So yes, maybe even this is about setting up some kind of business abroad, or this is about international reach there when it comes to your business or when it comes to your work. Thinking about a certain organization or a company that you are a part of. Then again, this could also be a case of you attending to a few legal matters. Certain legal matters need to be seen, need to be attended to, so that you are on the right track. Then we come to the end of Pluto in your sign, and Saturn, one of your chart rulers, will be in the 10th from 2041 until 2043 in Scorpio. So, my goodness, this could really be an enlightening time period. It could be like, whoa, my gosh, when I reflect on the past 20 years, all of this stuff has happened throughout my life. All these different areas have been activated, and I've been challenged, I've been tested, but I've also grown and I've evolved. And then pour all of that stuff into your career, your professional lives. Maybe you'll even look back and you go, well, I'm about to retire and I have acquired all of this and I appreciate that, but I also see how I have transformed throughout the process. Maybe even a part of it is you being in a position of authority where you're really feeling this inner strength. You feel like, yep, empowerment. And perhaps too, a part of it is giving that information out to the world, because this is what you do, Aquarius. Your sign is, well, your symbol is the water bearer, right? So you have the vessel and it's got water in it, and you pour it out to the world. So maybe a part of this with Saturn being the chart ruler is you doing that, you reaching a point where you go, whoa, you know, Pluto's been in my sign for so long and so much has happened, and I just I want to give this information. I need to give this information to others. Could be even quite a significant transit for your research there, what you're researching. Right. So what I want to say, Aquarius, here is with the journey explored, with your story, each chapter, relate the information back to that of your identity, your aims, your goals, your life path, and your appearance and your overall approach to life. This is about you, right? With Pluto in your sign over the next 20 years. And I just want to take a moment to say, good luck to you. I wish you all the best. Now, we're going to move on to Pisces. Thank you so much, Aquarius. Okay, Pisces, we are finishing off with you. Well, what does Pluto in Aquarius have in store for your sign over the next 20 years? Well, let's even think about how Pluto has been transiting the 12th house for Aquarians for the past 16 years or so. And what we could see then for you are these renewals and these pretty major eye-opening transformations with relation to your hidden self. But you see, your hidden self is different to that of the Aquarius. Your hidden self is that of the Aquarius traits. Let's try and break this down a little bit. I want to try and go slow with this one because this one could be quite heavy. So we think about the Aquarius traits such as being unique, being different, perhaps even being somewhat weird or unusual, and breaking the rules. There's a rebellious side to Aquarius, but there is also this humanity feel, really caring about fellow man and caring about where society is headed. So I think on a spiritual level, you are like this. On a spiritual level, when we look deeper, you, Pisces, are this sign, this archetype that feels it all. But you see, I think what you can find difficult to access within yourself is some healthy form of detachment. To be able to detach yourself from people, places, and things, and really experiences where you become somewhat enmeshed, you merge with others, you get lost in other people. So Pluto traveling through the 12th house over the next 20 years could indicate this empowerment or breaking away, endings, transitions, renewals, where you go, enough is enough. I don't want to connect to you anymore. I don't want to merge with you. What have I been bringing to this? Ugh, I don't like that. That makes me feel yucky that I've attached so strongly to this person or this situation. Or maybe even a part of it is to do with these flashes of insight, these aha moments to do with detachment, to detach, to separate. And following on from this, I want to just give appreciation to your sign, Pisces. And the reason why this is because I have been watching particular Piscean sun individuals on YouTube, and just the emotional intelligence when it comes to this sign is just incredible. The ability to hold space for for many emotions, to go through those emotional waves, to not judge, to not blame, to not criticize. We notice with your sign that, yeah, you are linked to meditation, stillness, tranquility. But that doesn't mean that you don't feel deeply. You can have this roaring emotional side to you, right, where your emotions are going crazy, but you can still learn to manage the waves. Or we could put it as ride the waves without becoming swallowed whole or drowning in them. And here's the thing, just to skip ahead a bit, Saturn has been in your sign since 2023, will be there until 2026. So you're already experiencing all of this. You are, I think, sort of paving the way for others. You are being a prime example of how to regulate and manage the emotional world, and how to also integrate parts of the self that are denied, repressed, and hidden. You, of course, are the sign that sort of says, I have one hand in the heavens, I have also one hand on the earth, grounded. Kind of like the magician card from the tarot, which you may find interesting because, I mean, symbolism, and with you Pisces, you may be interested in tarot and symbolism. So this, I feel, is like that representation of your symbol, right? These two fish that are swimming in two opposite directions. We could look at this as you being partly present, but partly absent, partly here, partly in another world, another dimension, tied to the heavens, but also tied to the earths. And there is that cord, right? There's the cord that connects you together. Well, maybe let me reword that in a different way. There's that cord that connects the two opposing parts of yourself together. We think about polarity here. So what I want to do now is I want to explore the next 20 years. And I think what's important to remember as we go through Uranus and Saturn is we got to bring it back. We will bring the journey, bring the story back to that of all of the subconscious stuff that will come up, your dreams, synchronicities, your visions, your imagination, right? The 12th house essentially is sort of like your domain. So Pluto is coming into the subconscious, and it could indicate all sorts of repressed emotions coming up. And this is also partly why I think you are paving the way for the rest of us. Especially think about how Pluto will enter your sign after Aquarius, and then how Saturn is in your sign, in the first house. And so you're going on this whole journey throughout the chart, right? You're thinking about those houses and how they represent different areas of life. So let's get into this. Uranus is currently hanging out in your third house. It has been there for a good while and will be there until 2027. So with Uranus in the third, maybe you recognize, Pisces, that so many visions and flashes of insight have been coming up for you intellectually, within communication, you know, thinking about how you converse with others there, engaging with others. Your social skills have been very much activated. Being surprised, really surprised by what comes through there, I think. And perhaps there is also a quality here of being shocked by the delivery of your message, the impact that it has on maybe helping others practically. Perhaps even a part of this is you suddenly changing your mind or suddenly exploring other parts of your local area, your local city, maybe being a bit adventurous, exploring the unknown. And there is this excitement. There's this exuberant sort of energy with Uranus, this buzz, right? So yeah, you could be engaging in activities where you're exploring, you're going on short distance trips, and it feels quite exciting for you. And then we also want to think about how Uranus will enter your fourth house from 2027 until 2034. So this part of the next 20 years, this part of your story could be about the twists and turns and the unexpected to do with family and your home life, your living situation, even considering healthy detachment, perhaps, when it comes to certain family members. Let's think of it this way again. So as I was saying, you know, with your sign, you can be this kind of sign that merges. You can merge. And, you know, I just also want to say, on a beautiful note, you can be empathetic, caring, kind, generous. My goodness, you can be such generous people. And just very, very giving in this emotional way, this spiritual way. But you see, I think Uranus can offer something of value here. Think about how Uranus and Saturn are the dispositors of Pluto for you in the 12th. So Uranus can offer something of value in that you can break away from particular, could be with Uranus and Taurus, sibling relationships, cousin relationships, just even thinking about immediate family. Then with Gemini, this could be breaking free from a family situation that maybe is very chaotic and it's full of drama and it's just gossip and hearsay and you don't know what the truth is and you're just like, I'm done, you know, I'm too intuitive for this, I don't need this, right? So there's this going on. And it could also be a case of a lot of movement. We see movement for you, flexibility, adapting to new situations. We just see this changeable energy, right? Whether this be you actually moving house or having more than one place where you live. Maybe this is even about how you change things up when it comes to your garden. So those are just examples. But then we come to 2034 until 2041, Uranus will enter your fifth. So this could be where there is this kind of rebelliousness to do with children you have. Maybe, you know, for some of you, your actual children will rebel more than usual, or they could just be at that stage of their lives where they're being rebellious teenagers. That's the thing about the next 20 years. I do understand that we can all be at different stages of our lives. But yeah, that's just one way to maybe look at this transit. And then another way could be that you explore the unexpected when it comes to how you enjoy yourself. And again, you know, how you enjoy yourself could be linked to family and your children and this closeness, showing affection. But maybe again, this is about some healthy detachment, you know, to have some healthy separation and individuation, actually, with respect to your individuality and your self-expression and your ego in some way, shape, or form. Then we come to 2041 until 2043, and Uranus will be in your sixth. So we kind of close Pluto and Aquarius with Uranus in your sixth, and this could be all sorts of mayhem and chaos to do with your working lives, your schedules, your routines. And you know, those surprises could come with their moments of excitement and joy, greater play. You know, maybe even a part of this is wanting to set things up in such a way where you have more free time, right? Where you're not just sort of tied to the normal way of doing things or having to be super consistent. You're actually at a point where, you know what, I want to break free. I don't want to have to do this same pattern anymore. I want to think about my own individuality and independence here. And naturally, when we think about how the sixth house opposes the 12th, maybe there's a part of it where you might clash in opinion with certain people there. It could be co-workers or employers, for example, but perhaps still with Pluto in your 12th, there is this strong push to want to do your own thing and to consider how you want to grow in life, right? Thinking about your hopes and wishes for the future. Now, Uranus shows the unexpected, the twists and turns, and the out of the blue stuff. But what we're going to do now is we're going to explore Saturn. Saturn is going to show structure and organization and limitation, delays, but also reward, hard work, success. And then with Saturn being one of the dispositors of Pluto in Aquarius, there's still an element of being experimental and trying new things. And I also want to say before we get into this, remember the overlaps. I've been saying this for all signs. Remember the overlaps between the dates. So look more into those overlaps for yourself. I mean, for example, just to draw from you, because Neptune is your chart ruler, well, one of your chart rulers, Saturn and Neptune will both enter Aries in 2025. But as you can see, I've got Saturn in Aries from 2026, but they'll dip back in, you see, back into your sign. So yeah, just remember overlaps and retrogrades. I mean, for example, Saturn in Pisces will make a trine to Uranus in Taurus. And Saturn in Aries will also make, a sextile, just to correct myself. Saturn in Pisces will make a sextile to Uranus in Taurus, and Saturn in Aries will make a sextile to Uranus in Gemini. Okay, with all of that out of the way, Saturn. Like I was saying earlier, Saturn has been in your sign since 2023, will be there until 2026. And so we're seeing greater maturity here when it comes to your life path. There's greater recognition of your energy and how you present yourself to the world, and having healthy boundaries, respecting your boundaries, respecting yourself in many ways, showing integrity, being a bit of an authority when it comes to your aims and your goals, and gaining this respectable way of, or just showcasing this respectable way of approaching new situations. Taking your time, being patient, considering emotional regulation, emotional maturity. Then we come to Saturn entering your second house from 2026 until 2028. So this could be where we notice greater authority and integrity and determination when it comes to your resources and your finances and your earnings. Maybe showing up as a bit of a sensible, productive leader. Maybe really thinking about the long haul when it comes to your financial goals, being more wise about the decisions that you make actually when it comes to your finances. So a lot of this, I think, is about being responsible and being disciplined too, showing self-discipline, maybe even being rewarded in some ways for your hard work. So this stuff then is tied to that of your physical security and your financial position. Then we come to 2028 until 2030, and Saturn will enter your third house. So I want to think of it this way. Uranus has been in your third house for a good while, will be there until 2027, indicating all of the epiphanies, all the realizations, the flashes of insight, all that good stuff. When it comes to communication, when it comes to learning, even, hey, when it comes to how you move throughout your local area, there's greater engagement there, trying new things, etc. Perhaps even sensual experiences, right, with Taurus, creative experiences, artistic experiences. But then Saturn, you see, will follow that same path just a while later. And that will be a good opportunity to bum ba dum bum build. Keep building, keep climbing, keep moving, right? So building and creating structure, bringing form, being sensible about these areas, maybe just reflecting and going, whoa, oh my gosh, this is what I learned from Uranus in my third house. And now this is what I'm going to apply, right? Practical application with Taurus, indeed. And maybe committing to a certain plan, a certain method, a certain way of teaching, way of learning, getting respect even for what you've been learning and presenting. Then we come to Saturn in your fourth. So Saturn will enter Gemini from 2030 until 2032. So this can be a good opportunity for you to be somewhat mature and responsible about family issues, family concerns, seeing what involves you, what doesn't involve you. Okay, that's not my responsibility, but this is my responsibility. Even greater boundaries and aligning even with your morals in a very strong way there too. And being more focused on, okay, what about the results here? How can we build as a family? What about our living situation? Can we consider the future? Let's think about a long-term plan here together. And the interesting thing about this is Saturn and Uranus will conjunct in Gemini at the end of June 2032. So that conjunction will usher in a new 45-year cycle for you to do with the likes of your living situation, your family, and your home. So there's an element of this that will be about the long haul, dedication, discipline, and so on. But there will also be a part of this where you can explore alternatives. Maybe it is about shakeups. Maybe it is about breakthroughs or breaking free, right? Breaking free from certain patterns. It could even be an emotional pattern thing and a habitual pattern thing, right? Where the unconscious is sort of explored there when it comes to your family. And maybe the past comes up quite a bit. But so that you can break away, break free, and move forward. Then we come to 2032 until 2035, and Saturn will be in the fifth for you. So this is where we could see some boundaries and limitations happening when it comes to your children. Could be disciplining children, or this could be about you showcasing this respectable and being sensible about how you converse with your children, thinking about the relationship that you have with them. It's what I'm getting from this is tough love, or what I'm getting from this is to come at things or to approach things in a more supportive, caring way, but to still get your point across. But with children to the side, you know, this could also be about memories you want to make with family, the fun you want to have, setting out a plan there, just organizing events in such a way where you can spend time with family or your loved ones. There is maybe a greater push for spending time with your romantic partner, and it's about connection, and it's about showing affection toward one another. There's still that supportive quality. And then, hey, you know, this could also be about a certain hobby or a creative pursuit that you're attached to, and you might want to engage with that more or practice more. There's more of that hard work that goes on and the effort that goes in. But just remember, Uranus will also be in Cancer for a period of time. So this part of it welcomes healthy detachment as well, and breaking free and rebellion and all the rest of it. Okay, so from 2035 until 2037, Saturn will be in your sixth. So here we're going to notice that there will be a great focus on your health. Think about even how Saturn and Pluto will make that opposition. So for you, this could be quite a tough one, honestly. You know, there could be some struggle, there could be some tension, limitation, especially if it is that you find yourself finding it difficult to cope. Okay, there's some difficulty with coping, especially with the everyday stuff, the practical stuff. Maybe a part of this is about your mental health, especially with Pluto in the 12th. Or, you know, this could even be related to the health of your children, the health of your romantic partner, or this perhaps could also pertain to that of your schedules and your routines. And yes, it could be about, right, having to be somewhat dedicated and serious, getting on with things, being quite practical in a way. But I think there could also be a part of it where you don't want to suck the fun out of the day. And maybe it could just feel like that period, or for some time period throughout that part of the story, you know, it could just feel like, oh, this isn't fun, I'm finding this really difficult. But just remember, you know, we all go through difficult times, we all experience challenges in our lives. Remember, with astrology, things move, you know, the time goes on, and the challenges are also important, and you can learn, right? You can learn major lessons maybe from a certain discipline that you're like, oh, I have to do this, I have to do this. But you can push through that, right? Maybe it is about some breakthroughs because of your ability to stay focused. Just as an example. Then we come to 2037 until 2039. Saturn will transit your seventh. So Saturn will be opposite you and could be creating some kind of pressure, honestly, because you think about it this way, you know, one of your chart rulers is Jupiter, and Saturn is so not Jupiter. It's like the opposite. But then again, you may look into that more and think on a philosophical level, you know, two sides of the same coin, da da da. But still, Saturn opposite you could be this time period of, oh, I have to do this. And, you know, people are telling me that these are my responsibilities and these are my duties, and there just could be a lot of work and a lot of service related stuff that comes up, and you just have to chug away at it and put in a lot of time. Maybe even a part of this is giving over some responsibility to other people so they can do their part. And maybe also perfectionism coming from others, critical people, nitpicking, this kind of thing. But hey, on a lighter note, this could be about improvement and refinement and making things that little bit better within business relationships. And maybe you may find that a certain contract or an agreement is signed, and then there are major improvements made to your life because of that. Again, though, remember with Saturn, you gotta put in the work. Okay, from 2039 until 2041, Saturn will enter the eighth for you. So this one, actually, I would say, could invite some kind of limitation or delays and setbacks, blockages, to do with your partner. So it could be more of a financial thing, thinking about your partner's money, your partner's resources, or this could be more of an intimate thing. Maybe just having to get serious about the hard questions. This is what we're seeing, okay? There could be a few hard questions that you address with your significant other. Again, this could be related to that of business deals, business partnerships, maybe even just seeing eye to eye. And those, you know, the seeing eye to eye and trying to come to some kind of agreement, hopefully a win-win outcome, such things could be tied to shared resources. You know, thinking about even the amount of money you have invested into a certain company or business, for example. And it is just kind of about your share, right? What am I getting from this? And even just to finish with this one, there could be some blockages that you address within yourself when it comes to relating and collaborating. Then lastly, we come to the end of Pluto in Aquarius. And Saturn will be in Scorpio in the ninth house for you from 2041 until 2043. So actually, we could see you being a bit of an expert or a professional when it comes to teaching, mentoring, guiding. See, with Scorpio in your ninth, you do tend to pick up on the things that people overlook and they don't see. You look beneath the surface, you see, and you get people questioning, you get people thinking, looking within. So maybe there could be something about how you broadcast this knowledge, these truths of yours to the world, and how those things can even somehow be tied to your own psychological transformations that occur, your own spiritual transformations that occur up until that point, right? With Pluto being in Aquarius. Pisces, thank you so much. And with that, we have completed all of the signs. Thank you all for being here. Thank you for your patience if you waited for part two. But that is Libra through to Pisces. Part one has Aries through to Virgo, just to let you know. But folks, this has been the Pluto and Aquarius story. A lot of information, but I really hope that you can use your sign as a bit of a tool to help you throughout your journey, okay? Especially here, looking to the rising sign naturally, okay? The rising sign can be very useful, but I always say too that the sun and moon can be somewhat significant, especially looking to the sun if you have a day chart and looking to the moon if you have a night chart. And even those of you with stelliums, you know, we've got a cluster of planets in a certain sign. Just remember derivative houses, you know, where you turn the wheel and you kind of put those planets in the first house and you look at it from there. Yeah, things could apply there too. Thank you all so much for listening. If you would like to book a reading with me, you can visit my website, hannahselsewhere.com. And if you really did enjoy your horoscopes, you can always buy me a coffee, but there is never any pressure. And just to let you know of the options available. Good luck, everybody. Yes, good luck during this transit with Pluto in Aquarius. I hope that it brings you many blessings and rewards, but even through the tough times, even through the challenges, I hope you grow and you learn. Thank you, and I will talk to you in the next video. Bye.